Supposed to open from 9 till 9, 2 hours at the end of the day for extra magic hours, and a half an hour early in the morning. Well, I make it 8:15, they've already let us in. So what are we going to do with our little bit of extra time? Wait and see. What's this? No, this is Connections Cafe. We've never been here before, have we?
No, it's new.
Alright, but that's not the replacement for the electric umbrella, is it?
And this is where Starbucks is now.
Yes, I'm sure we'll be visiting there at some stage today.
Yeah.
Now, yesterday, we never got on Seven Dwarfs, did we?
Well, no, we could have done, but we didn't want to queue for 50 minutes, did we?
It was just the lowest it ever went was 50 minutes, and that's probably, in my opinion, still the biggest and for queue-wise that people want to go on.
Well, and Peter Pan though. Peter Pan was longer sometimes.
So I would say, ride-wise, would you say that Test Track is normally quite a long queue?
Yeah, it can be.
Well, we're just approaching now, and that's where we're going. Just in case you were wondering, that's what we're going to do with our extra time. See if we can get into a Test Track standby, and it's not too long, hopefully. Where's your backpack? I know you were very proud of. Let's have a look. Is it lounge fly?
Yeah, it's my wonderful flowering garden. It's got flowers on within it.
A very beautiful coordinated outfit you've got on today.
Oh, thank you so much. Love composite.
Right, and it looks like the standby is 15 minutes.
Woohoo!
We're going to take advantage of that.
Let's get on test.
Right, we've just done Test Track. Our vehicle scored 211. But the top score was 220. So next time we got 9 more to find.
Yeah,
submission.
Exactly.
I love the Frozen ride. I didn't get wet. Somebody did. Where did you get wet?
On the bottom.
On the bum. Well, that said 60 minutes standby. We were in, queued, and off the ride in 29.
That was a result, wasn't it?
So that's a big result.
Yeah.
Maybe it's because we were there before the rest of the park opened. Do you think so?
Yeah.
Here we go. This is brand new for us. Never done this bit before. You looking forward to it? I am. There we go, Ratatouille all done and dusted.
I enjoyed it. 30. Pretty good.
Yeah, okay. It made me feel motion sick.
Yeah, you do get motion sick there.
But I did give it a try, and yeah, it's a solo rider from now on, I think.
It was very good. The theme was amazing.
Well, I had my eyes closed for about half of it.
So the theme was really good. I really enjoyed it. So yeah, thumbs up me. So I'm glad we did it, but yeah, I'll do it on my own for now.
The queuing system was nice, it was well themed. We've had our Kringler and coffee. What else did we do? We just done Figment, and now we're going to go into the seas with Nemo and friends.
We're going to go see Nemo!
Nemo! Well, if we can find him. Hey, hello there. Right, we've finished up at...
Back at Saratoga Springs.
Yeah, back at Saratoga Springs. We had a very productive 4 hours this morning. It's about 4 hours, wasn't it? We got there around about 20 past eight. We left at 20 past 12. have we already made a video of what we managed to do? We got five rides. We did the Frozen. We managed to get Ratatouille, but that I didn't feel too great after that. Test Track, Figment. Where else? Can you remember the other one? There was one more.
You said Frozen.
Said Frozen.
You said the Ratatouille.
Said Ratatouille. Anyway, we got five. We got five rides. Oh, Nemo.
Nemo.
Oh, and the Mexico. So we did six.
Yeah.
Where you got? There you are. So we did six in that 4 hours. We've come back to Saratoga Springs because we didn't because it's extra magic hours tonight, and we didn't want to be there from 8:30 in the morning till 11 at night. I don't think even we could do that. So I just clarified it with guest services that if we leave, we can go back and it doesn't classify like a park hopper thing. Apparently when you book for a park, a reservation, you have it all day. So I definitely got that clarified. I made it shorter. So when we come back later on, to make use of the extra magic hours, we're not going to get cut out, we're not going to be told you can't come in. She said no, you can definitely come back. We actively encourage our customers to go back, take a nap, and then come back again later on.
I do like a good nap.
So we've come back to Saratoga Springs. We've had
some lunch.
I had a turkey club sandwich. You had that yesterday and it looked really good, so I had it and that was very nice. Must have been very nice. Never had a sandwich with so much turkey in it.
I'm gonna go back and have a relaxed bit, aren't we?
Got a drink, got
I'm gonna have a little coffee.
Got a Fanta.
I'm gonna have a little coffee probably.
And
then a little watch a little bit of telly and relax a little bit.
Oh, I think there's gonna be this the relax means it's gonna be a snooze. And I think that's a good idea. Right, let's go for it. Hey, how you doing?
Hiya, I'm good. How are you?
Not too bad. We've just we've been in Epcot. Now we're going around World Showcase and we're looking at some food and drink.
For the Flower and Garden.
For the Flower and Garden. I nearly said food and wine then. So we're at America at the moment. We'll spin around and have a look at the Magnolia Terrace. So I'm not sure what takes your fancy there. A spicy chicken gumbo looks like it might be something that'll set me running. Or the pecan praline sounds nice.
I think I'm alright for this one.
No, we're going to give this one a miss, are we?
Yeah, is there anything you want on this one?
I might have tried the pecan praline, but I think I'd fancy something savoury rather than sweet straight away.
I just love the flowers. It's in Pluto.
Yeah, I must admit, how they've themed it all. There he is, there's Pluto.
We are on.
We just had a lovely drink with Valerie and Jim.
Yeah.
Some friends that you converse with on
Facebook.
We've just been to the German Pavilion where we had a very nice beer, flavoured. Now, was it raspberry?
I think it was
raspberry.
It was very nice.
I've forgotten already. Jim kindly bought us those drinks. They've gone off. We've gone off now to get something to it.
Really,
but it was
nice.
Really nice.
Really
we were there for just over an hour.
Yeah, lovely couple.
Having a chat. It was really nice to meet them. And
they just told us what Japan shop was like, how empty it is.
Yeah.
We've just been in ourselves.
Just been in Mitsukoshi to see if we can find some stuff for our son at home. But there's hardly anything there. It just seems to be the supply chains are really struggling at the
usually
moment.
Usually we come back with lots of nothing here.
Far too much.
Yeah. And there's nothing. It's going to be disappointed this year, I think.
Yeah, he will be. Yeah, he will be. Never mind. Well, one of those things. We just have to make up to him somehow when we get home.
Yeah, exactly. So we're going to try and find some food now.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to try some...
Jim recommended, and Valerie recommended that there was a burger.
Oh, yeah.
Over at the French Pavilion. So we're working our way around. We start from Germany. We've just come to Japan and we're going on to see what we can find.
Go and get some sushi.
Yeah, have something to eat. Right.
See you later.
This is the Japan Pavilion. They've got hanami. There's the frushi.
Let's go and get some frushi.
Let's get some frushi. Chicken yakitori, beef tataki, water, and then I'm not sure about the pineapple sake, but I'm sure we'll find some. Let's have a look. Frushi, frushi, frushi. One delivery of frushi for my lady.
Thank you.
In fact, it matches your top. Did you know?
No.
Right, what do you think of that bit? I think, can't remember, what did they say the frushi was wrapped? It was it mango? Was it mango? Something to do with fruit rice, of some sort of cream. How does it taste? Is it really nice, is it? It smells lovely, I must admit. Now then, bearing in mind, and melon, isn't there? Now, bearing in mind, you said you've been wanting to eat this for quite some time now.
That's really nice.
Out of 10, what would you give it?
About a seven.
Oh, okay, seven and a half then. Seven and a half, right, I'll let you eat the rest in peace. Well, that's my first ever go of frushi, and I liked it. In fact, I give it more than a 7.5 out of 10. I'd give that an 8. I thought that was quite nice. I would definitely have that again. Right, halfway between Morocco and France is La Isla Fresca. What have they got here? Arepas topped with melted queso fresco. Arepa topped with chorizo, coconut, tre leche, vanilla cake soaked in oat milk, almond milk, coconut milk with toasted coconut, which is that one there. Oh, the tropical breeze, lemonade, grapefruit and simple syrup. Sounds quite nice. And then the tropical breeze with Don Q limon rum. Sounds nice. Anything there take your fancy? And there you go, that's the front of their little pavilion. Oh, it's got a Disney Encanto. We've arrived in France, this is the fleur-de-lis. What was Jim talking about? Was it the burger, wasn't it, he said?
I thought he said about a drink. The burger was over in that restaurant. He said about a drink here.
Oh, right, okay.
No, was it the cocktail?
Oh, the slushy.
He said about the slushy.
Did you want to try one of the slushies?
I need a bit more treat first.
You want a bit more treat? I'll tell you what then. What I always like about the French air is it's a great place for eating and meeting, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's just round there, Remy. Oh, she spotted something. I see what it is. It's Cogsworth and Lumiere. at the UK cider house, the top of the list, the BLT scone with Nueski's applewood smoked bacon, sun-dried tomato and basil. That sounds nice. The dark chocolate raspberry tart, that's probably more your thing. And then
snake bite. That sounds nice. Bold Rock watermelon hard cider.
The Bold Rock watermelon hard cider from Nellisville. This isn't coming across as quite British, but Cider Boys Tropical Wave and Sam Smith. Now that's more like it. Okay, anything there that takes your fancy?
That's where you get it from over there. I think I'm going to try the BLT.
Oh, and there you go. And there's the Cider House Pavilion. Hello, mate. We're in the UK. I can just about pick it up. What do we get?
The BLT scone.
The BLT scone.
Or scone, if you call it scone.
Scone, well, it depends. Right. All right.
Let's try it.
We're underneath a light lamp, and it's very dim because they're just about to start the 9 o'clock show's not too far away. Oh, there we go, I can just about catch your face.
It's quite hard and crispy, it's nice though.
What would you give it out of 10? Bear in mind you give the Frushi 7.5. Is it better or worse?
No, the Frushi about 8.
Frushi's at 8, or you've upgraded the Frushi.
This about
6.5. Oh, right, okay. Right, I'll give it a go and see what we think. Well, I've just tried that. To be honest, I thought that was absolutely rubbish. I didn't even want to finish off my half. I've given the rest to the wife, and luckily the wife likes to eat meat, so she's having that. Looks like I'm sat by a campfire, doesn't it? Out here, out in the wilds, we've captured our own food and cooked up some rubbish. Northern Bloom in Canada. They've got seared scallops with French beans, butter potatoes, brown butter, vinaigrette, applewood smoke, bacon. That sounds quite nice. Beef tenderloin tips. That's the picture there.
I'm going to have that.
That looks quite impressive.
Yeah.
A grilled maple pound cake. Which is that. That looks nice. But the seed scallops look quite nice, actually.
They do as well.
What do you fancy? And then you've got, for the drinks, a maple popcorn shake, Glutenberg Blonde Ale, Collective Arts Brewing Blueberry Fruit Beer. That could be my sort of thing. 81 Bay Brewing Company Apricot. They lurk these flavours. A beer flight. And a maple popcorn shake with Tap 357 Maple Rye Whiskey. That's all a lot of stuff, and that's where it is in there. We're just stopping off at the Honey Bistro. There's the menu. We've ordered a lavender honey mustard marinated chicken flatbread and a local wildflower honey mascarpone cheesecake. And that's the flatbread. And that's the cheesecake, and that's some of the drinks they've got there. And that is the Honey Bistro Pavilion. We found a little area around the side. Here she is, waiting patiently for me. Right, here we go. I've just had a quick look at the board. So there's the flatbread
and cheesecake.
And the cheesecake.
Let's go.
Right, you're going for the bit of the flatbread. What's it like? Now then, here's the question. Better or worse than that awful BLT scone we had in the United Kingdom? Better or worse than the Frushi? You can give me a thumbs up, you don't have to talk. Better or worse, thinking about it. Oh, it's close. Oh.
Frushi wins,
wow. Right, and then of course we've got the cheesecake as well. Right, I'm gonna have a little bit of this now. Well, that flatbread was surprisingly on a par with the BLT scone that we just had from the UK. That's all for you, darling. It's all yours, you can do it. Oh, God, that was horrible. It's me, I'm back again. Just had some of the cheesecake. The honey was quite nice, actually. I quite like that. See what you think. I know you don't like honey, so I've had all of that. The cheesecake is nice. There's a little bit of honeycomb on it. That cream that you're about to eat there, that's really nice. I must admit, that is very, very nice. I was so interested on the food, I forgot to actually video.
Nice.
I think that's probably... No, it's all you. I'm not sure what that is then, is it?
Meringue
thing, is it? It wasn't really, it was a little bit crunchy, but then gooey, smooth.
I think you might have got the flatbread.
The flatbread, yeah, we're not too impressed with the flatbread. That's consigned. Oh, monorail. That's consigned to the garden bin at Flower and Garden. The cheesecake, I'd probably give it about a 5. I think the best thing we've had tonight so far was the drink that Jim and Valerie got us. So, just goes to show something about the food when the drink's the best thing. I've started videoing.